That is some weird, wild stuff. That is funny. I did not know that.
Yes!
Dropping drawers and stabbing whores on the Kevin Holly Show.
And I gotta say, he has balls. This man has balls. He's laying them out there for us to see.
That's like, it sounds like our first date kit.
Ever shared a lustful evening with a Muslim woman?
We're dropping drawers and stabbing whores. It's the Kevin Holly Show.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Kevin Holly Show.
Yeah.
We are live. It is July 4th, 1776. Once again, this is, what, episode 25, the second show of our second season?
Second
is that right?
Show
oh, my second God. Season. I have spent 25 evenings with you gentlemen, and nobody's bled yet?
Actually, I got bit by a dog again today, right when I came here, dude.
Kevin's bled twice doing this show.
I'm not talking about spotting.
Well, listen, to my right, once again, the legendary Homeless Chuck. What's up, dude?
I'm the man in the box. I live on the podcast with Kevin and Jay. Give me shit.
All right.
Chuck's in a good form tonight. Yeah, this is going to be a great show, man.
You know, and right
now, Pops is giving me the sparkly blues. Can I introduce Pops?
Go ahead, bro.
Good evening, Pops. I love your sparkly blues.
Yes, I know.
He's coming.
How you doing, Pops?
What?
I said, how you doing, Pops?
Compared to what?
I don't know.
The living and the dead.
The Take Five.
Oh, listen, Pops has Pops brought some content to the table tonight. He's got his red folder, and he's got some sports trivia. And I did get to peek at it, and that was before last week's episode. I don't remember everything I saw. I do remember one part about it, but I think it'll be pretty interesting.
All right. Sounds good.
Directly in front of me, my man, our executive producer, reproduction agent, Mr. Jay Bird.
Let's give him a golf clap. Everybody, let's give Jay Bird a golf clap. My God, dude, the money he's put into the studio
really?
Recently. All of our listeners out there, I now have honest to God, microphone. I have, honest to God, a microphone stand.
Mm-hmm.
For those that weren't aware, for almost a year now, I was talking into a lamp that was rigged with a microphone.
Yeah, and he thought it talked back, too.
Exactly.
He's having conversations with
it. I've got something to say, my friend. Kiss. But, no, you remember the Talking Heads wrote that song about Son of Sam, Kiss Kisse. Anyhow,
well,
no.
Well, listen, I mean, I know people can't see this on when they're listening to us, but Chuck has a board right there. If you want to just, like, turn to your right a little bit,
you can
turn knobs and stuff and act like you're, like, doing something really great. I mean, I have to say.
It's all like all the shitty tickets I bought at the concerts back in the 70s. Although, you know, sitting behind the music board back in the 70s, you heard the best music. Your line of vision sucked. But I'm telling you, all you had to do was do a little bribery and you were in front row, man.
Well, listen, I just want to, you know, to start the show off, I want to thank our listeners. We've already got a whole slew of people in the chat room. Go on mixlr.com. If you're not already there listening to us live, there is a chat feature. It's pretty cool. We will talk to you guys throughout the show. I really appreciate that. That's always a lot of fun. Also, our phone number tonight, if you want to call on the show, is 727-237-6010. You can check us out on Facebook. It's The Kevin Holly Show. And also on Twitter, at Kevin Holly Show 4. Write it down. Keep it safe. You need that.
Yeah.
So if you're ever going to get laid this year, you need to listen to the Kevin Holley Show.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
especially if you're, you know, trisexual like Chuck. He'll try anything.
No, but seriously, you know, all the kids that go out nowadays, they're on dates. They don't interact. All they do is look at their phones. So if you're looking at the Kevin Holley Show while you're out on a first date, it's going to engage you.
Yeah.
It's going to intrigue you.
Probably will get you laid.
You need to make dialogue. Our show is to connect people. Well, get away from your electronic devices. Although, Kevin, what can they reach us on again? I'm just kidding.
No.
We're going to get so, you know, electronic Chuck, what devices.
What I wanted to say is, like, if you're listening to the Kevin Holley Show, you don't have to listen to your, you know, you don't have to look at your phone. You could just simply be playing it. Like, and have an earbud in, right, and just be right. Like, oh, yeah.
Dude, right, I would highly... Right.
We need to do a first date episode where we give the guy the clues on how to get laid. Like a dinner, like a first date episode.
Well, Chuck, if you're going to give other dudes clues on how to get laid, I mean, that's a little weird, bro. I mean, it's not a big deal, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you're screaming about you haven't been laid for 3 years. I mean, how are you going to teach anybody else how to
not
do
with
that?
A woman, anyway.
Oh, Pops, I had skills back in the goddamn days, baby. Jesus Christ.
It's like riding a bicycle just because he isn't, exactly. Just because he doesn't do it doesn't mean he doesn't know how.
Doesn't
so.
Mean I don't have freaking yeah. Game, man. Yeah. You know, Valentine's Day, we just passed. That was my favorite holiday to ever go out
no,
on.
No, you're not going to do it.
No,
don't.
No, give me one moment. Yeah. Give me one moment, Pops. I used to go to New York for like 30 years. It was a meat market for 40 years. The place was up and running. I always looked for the girls that were stirring the drink real slow and looking down at the drink going, well, I got nothing today. And all of a sudden I'd be like, hi, how the hell are you? You got something today? I'm Charles. How the hell are you? I'm going to do disgusting things to you and never call you again. Happy Valentine's Day.
All right, so Pops, your take on Valentine's Day? Or Chuck, whatever you have to, whatever.
Well, I didn't really understand what he just said, but
I know. I'm like, I'm so glad you interrupted Pops.
I don't think he did either, but
the lampshade totally got it there, dude.
Yeah.
We
were talking about Chuck giving somebody telling him how to get laid.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And right. you said that because you hadn't been laid didn't mean that you didn't know how.
It just doesn't take him as long now.
I mean, you know how, but you don't know how, is what you're trying to tell me.
No, I'm just telling you that ever since I had the breathalyzer in my vehicle, it's kind of hard to go out and troll around in the goddamn meat market bars because...
Isn't that like dudes, the meat market bars? What the hell is that? Listen, Chuck, step one, find a girl.
Try to do stuff. Step two. Well, introduce her to her mom.
Having heard Chuck's past comments about sex and stuff, I'd say step number one, find somebody to want to have sex.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, or some...
Doesn't necessarily have to be a girl.
Or some chloroform, you know. Step two, chloroform.
Or exactly, you know, unfortunately I have references throughout a gazillion shows. The Bill Cosby behavior. I'm powerful, and here's a quaalude.
See, right away he's got to get racist on us.
I'm not racist.
Yeah, well, check that off the board, Chuck.
Talking
racist.
About
check.
Talking about date raping right away, he's got to bring Bill Cosby.
I'm not racist. Did you say Bing Crosby? I would never race a black guy. They're Crosby. Very fast.
Okay.
Listen, all right. Yeah, let's turn this around another way right now. Let's talk about what's happening in the world right now.
Well, first off, bro, I would like to throw out a thank you to Slingshot Robot for showing up in studio live last
jumping,
week and
baby.
Kicking
Jesus,
ass, man.
They played well.
Weren't they awesome?
That was good.
Dude, I've been playing that show all the time. I played some of that music for the kids.
You know, I looked at some of their plug-in music, and it doesn't hold my interest. Their unplugged music, it was absolutely fucking spectacular. I don't know how I'm telling you, the musicianship, they were tight. And you know, we brought these guys in off the street. We played in here. I mean, not off the street, but you know what I'm saying. But also, we're jamming them up in our studio, and they were spot on. They were tight. They were nice.
They're good guys, too, man. Yeah. I like them all.
Yeah, a couple of them hung out, and
what's his name? Ed. He stayed all night, man. I went out for the third break. He's still out there.
Yeah, he's just hanging out. He was here when I was calling a cab home the other night, man. He flagged the cab down for me, man.
Hey, Slingshot Robot, if you're listening, guys,
what's his name?
Ed.
Ed. The first dude that showed, man.
Singer. Hello. Yeah. It's a quick quiz time for you. What's his name? Come on.
I've been drinking already. I knew his name tomorrow. I was like, when I woke up, I was
like. You
didn't
know his name the following morning when you were cuddling.
Left his gear bag here. He left his guitar case here.
Yeah. Come pick it up, dude. Yeah,
exactly. Slingshot Robots. We have some of your musical instruments and some of your cases still around. So
No instruments. Just a guitar bag.
Yeah, and Jay, I asked him if he looked
through
it.
Jay has a vague memory of his instrument.
Really? You're going to insult our guests like that? They'll never come back on, Chuck.
No, I said Jay has a vague memory of his instrument.
But you're talking about his instrument, Chuck.
You're implying that Jay saw it, that he exposed himself to Jay. That didn't happen.
No, I'm implying that you serviced him. That doesn't make him gay. That makes you gay.
Pops, are you going to stand in on this or what, man? I mean, let's...
Pops, is your son gay?
Hey, listen.
Not my son and FBA.
Let's get into what's on the second hour, man.
Guys?
Wait, we're still in the first hour, Jay Bird.
I want to talk about what's coming up, man.
Thanks for pointing that out, Chuck. We've got another special guest calling in the show tonight, and it's going to be Don from the band The Tosspints. Now, if you guys listened to The Mongrels a few weeks ago, you may recall us talking about who's who in the band. Looking at some pictures online and whatnot, and Jay mistook Don for the singer of the Mongrels, but in reality, that really was Don. He was the bass player for the Mongrels, and now he's the guitar player and lead vocalist for the Tosspints, which I think that's a pretty badass name, the Tosspints. I thought Chuck would probably really identify with that.
I think the Tosspints, but what I also like to reiterate, Kevin, you cannot condemn Jay on the men that he finds attractive. It's not his fault.
Hey, all right, listen, on that note, I just like to tell you something, man. And Kevin, I hope you're going to post this, but we bought a new board for the show this week, and it's a badass board. And that's big. Hooked everything up. Like, there's a lot of cables involved in doing this show.
That's what Jay does, laying cables.
Lay some serious cable. And I'll tell you what,
you laid some board too, right?
Right before the show.
Like 15 minutes before we started.
Kevin's like, I'm not happy. So he starts ripping cables out of new board.
Did you get him the 4-ply toilet paper and the phone books?
He took a poop before the show. How was it?
Always take a nervous poop. We were banging on the door talking about post-production.
You were banging on the door?
Yeah. You were in the bathroom, and Jay and I are both banging on the door, going over the whiteboard, not necessarily saying we're racist. We just have a dry ease board, and you were in there pooping prior to every show.
Bro, I was in there getting my hair and makeup done. You know what I'm saying?
Oh.
Anyway, listen, I was in the bathroom, and I'm like, Jay! He comes walking by, and he's like, you need baby wipes again? And I'm like, no, dude, 4-ply is cool, bro, thank you. Anyway, I'm like, rip the cables off that new board and put the old one back in. Let's do this, because I'm not comfortable with it, man. I hadn't had a chance to get familiar with it, and it's huge, dude.